In the year 1630, on board the ship Arbala, while crossing the Atlantic Ocean, John Winthrop preached a sermon called A City on a Hill. The ship was headed for what would eventually become the United States of America, and for a city that would one day be known as Boston, Massachusetts. After arriving, the Puritans, with Winthrop as their governor, went about making this vision a reality by creating a well-structured, stable Christian society. The city prospered greatly under this vision, so much so that by the time of the American Revolution, Boston was America's wealthiest, most successful, and influential city. The Revolution was a difficult time, though, for the city, as it hosted events like the Boston Massacre, the Boston Tea Party, the Battle of Lexington and Concord, and of course, Bunker Hill. Boston was scarred. Within a few years, Boston had totally lost its original vision as a city on a hill. Today, the spiritual condition of Boston is shocking in light of its original vision. Only about 2.5% of the 6 million people in greater Boston ascribe to the gospel of Jesus Christ as the way to salvation. Take that into perspective, that means 5.85 million people do not believe in salvation by faith alone, in Christ alone. If you were to go across the city of Boston today, in fact, you would see many churches that once existed are no longer churches at all. Many of them have been sold and are now things like condominiums and even a karate studio. So you might ask, why would we come here? Why would we focus on this city? Well, it's not unlike the strategy that the Apostle Paul used early in Christian times. You see, if you stop and think about it, 120 believers at the time, shortly after Christ's resurrection and ascension, managed to reach the entire Roman Empire on three different continents within just a few hundred years. So how did they do it? Well, they focused on the great, big, beautiful, dangerous cities like Boston, cities like Philippi, Ephesus, Corinth, and Rome. And that's how they managed to reach the Roman Empire. Today, if we want to reach a nation like America, it has to begin in the cities because everything trickles down from the cities. Culture begins in the cities. Education, economics, politics, even moral values begin in the city and trickle down. That's why we're here. That's why God's called us here. And our desire is to plant a church that will plant churches across this great city. I'm sitting on the steps of the chapel at Boston University. Boston University is the largest university in the Boston area and is the fourth largest independent university in America. It's home to some 32,000 students at any given time. This site is less than a mile from where we will be planting. But Boston University is just the tip of the iceberg here in Boston. Right around this area, there are schools like Boston College, Northeastern University, which is home to 20,000 plus students, Berklee College of Music, Simmons College, Emmanuel College, and Harvard Medical College. These are right around the area where we are planting. And Boston itself is home to 70 colleges and universities with over 250,000 college students. It's been rightly nicknamed the Athens of America. You know, in the book of Acts, chapter 17, Paul preaches in Athens. When he preached, he got three different responses. One group had questions. They wanted to know more. What is this Jesus you're talking about? Some just outrightly rejected. They couldn't grasp the idea. And yet others at that time were ready and did receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. We believe here in Boston, the Athens of America, that we'll run into the three same responses that Paul did, that there will be those who just reject the gospel and walk away. We'll pray for them. We'll seek to love them. But there will be others who will have questions, serious questions, and we'll be there to try to help them find answers in God's Word. And finally, we believe that there are many here in this city who are ready to receive Jesus Christ, many college students, many young adults, professionals. God has called us here to reach this population. What if God gave us the ability to impact this population in this area? Could raise up a whole generation of Christian leaders across this country. the city itself actually touches the world in a very real way. It said at any given moment, 20% of the developing nation's future leaders are studying at one of the universities here in Boston. So we could quite literally touch the world through this church plant. I'm standing here at the corner of Harvard and Beacon Street, an area of Boston known as Coolidge Corner. Coolidge Corner is the birthplace of President John F. Kennedy and is known for its great history around Boston. It was the mid-1800s when two brothers decided to open a store here called Coolidge and Brothers, and thus the name of Coolidge Corner began. It was a few years later, in the mid-late 1800s, when Beacon Street, which runs along here, was widened in order to make room for train cars. And today, still a major train route and what's called the Green Line of Boston. The history extends into 1900, where the building behind me was built, and then 1933, where the famous Coolidge Corner Theater was established and still looks very much like it did at that time. It still shows first-rate movies today. That's the history, but we're here for the present. Coolidge Corner remains one of the most influential areas of Boston. You might ask, well, why did you choose this spot? Well, there's a lot of opportunities here, many young people. Within just a mile of this spot right here, the average age is 29 years old. Almost 30% of the population has a graduate degree of some kind. These are the present and future leaders of the city of Boston. The reason we have targeted this area in particular is because of our relationship with a church called Hope Fellowship Church. 5 years ago, Hope Fellowship Church started in Cambridge, just 5 miles north of here. God has blessed their ministry. About a year ago, they decided to look for an area to try to reach. So they started doing a Sunday night service here in Coolidge Corner because they had some people from this area that were driving all the way up to their main campus, and because they desired to see an evangelical witness in the area. God has blessed that group, it's grown, and the elders at Hope Fellowship Church now feel like that group is ready to take off and move towards becoming an independent church. They've asked me to consider being their lead planter. That's what God has laid on our heart, and we're moving towards that. Our desire is to make an impact in this area, to plant our lives here, to be here long term, to see this church grow, prosper, and reach many people across this area and plant other churches. But the challenges are great. Boston is one of the most expensive places to live in the United States, and Coolidge Corner in particular is very expensive. But God has called us here, and we believe that He will call the people alongside us to serve with us, to encourage us. We're looking for people that will come and plant their lives here, people who love northeastern winters, who love snow and cold weather, but more than that, people who love this city and desire to see many people come to Christ. We also believe God is calling people to pray for us, to partner with us, to serve and help plug in into what we're doing. But we also believe God is calling some people to give, maybe people who'll never come to Boston, but who see the need here and feel touched by God to support what's happening. We ask you to prayerfully consider that.